Hey there guys, welcome back to the channel and thank you so much for coming back to another video of ours. Today I'll be going through how to execute a flawless full cycle BRR property investment. BRR stands for buy, refurbish, refinance. And what I've come to realize doing well over 45 BRR properties executed flawlessly for investors back to back is that nobody actually truly knows what is a flawless BRR cycle and what is actually required to grow a significant portfolio using a small pot of cash in a very, very short amount of time. I'm going to be showing you guys around one of my ongoing BRR properties. Now, this is a property that I've sourced for an investor of ours at the beginning of the month of May. My construction company has done the entire refurb, which I'll be going inside and showing you guys exactly what we have done. And I will also be breaking down all of the numbers involved with this deal. Now, the investor that I've sourced this property for has done multiple projects with us and is actually the finance director of one of the largest companies here in the UK. And I'm talking a multi-billion pound company. As you can see, we've had the entire front garden of the property stripped back and cut out. Now, what we basically do is we deliver these full cycle BRR property investments for our investor at exact guaranteed timeline. Now, basically, what comes to really finding BRR properties like this, firstly, comes down to be able to negotiate them to an amazing standard and being able to deliver on the refurb. As you can see, coming into the property, we've kept the front UPVC composite door. Now, this door didn't need changing at all, but as you can see, we've had a lot of progress made on the inside. I secured this property on modern method of auction for our investor. Now, this property needed a lot of work. So as you guys can see, we've already got a nice, bright, white finish. Now, this property consisted of brand new central heating, brand new electrics being pulled through, plaster works throughout the entire property, external board insulation getting the EPC C and above, brand new architraves, skirting boards throughout the property, a couple new frames around where need be, a couple new doors where need be as well, new handles, everything fixed up throughout the property, brand new kitchen, brand new bathroom. Everything needed to get this property up to achieve a high end value for our investor. Making our way into the front reception room of this property, as you can see, it is completely being transformed. Now, we've had all the central heating pipes put in under the floorboards and new central heating pulled through throughout the property. These walls that you see here are external walls. So basically, we have external wall insulation, so that's plasterboard with 50 mil thick foam behind it to come on top of the previous walls, which we took back to pretty much the brick or pretty much the old bonding and plaster works where need be to redo it. Now, we've obviously stuck it on with PVA, dot and dab, and everything that needs to be done to get the property renovation done. We've replastered the entire of the property where need be. One thing you guys may, some of you may see, is that the ceilings have still been kept the same. Now, there's a reason for that. Obviously, we do these refurbishments in a set budget, and the plan is to pretty much treat these as a specific investment. So our entire goal is to achieve a specific end value and a specific rental income. Now, we've achieved this every single time that we've done it because we know exactly what we do. And it's very, very important that when you guys are doing complete refurbs, that you take in consideration that you guys need to add a few certain things. Now, by adding external board insulation, getting your EPC to a C and above, that defeats the purpose of somebody buying a property and pretty much just painting over wallpaper, because you've got to redo all of the walls. So I'll get some photos up of how that pretty much looks to get the EPC of the property up. Basically, what that kind of does is just keeps the property a lot warmer, insulates the walls, pretty much improves the energy performance certificate of the property. This property in specific didn't need any windows or any doors, so that was an amazing thing to keep an eye out when you are buying property. Does it need new windows and does it need new doors? Those are a small cost that you guys definitely need to take in consideration for. This dining room slash lounge that you see here, we've had all of the previous woodwork, all the architraves, all the skirtings removed and disposed of. We had burnt majority of the wood back in the rear garden, and we got some skips to dispose of it, and pretty much got all the rubbish and all the strip of this property completed. Now, obviously, the first steps were to get this property completely stripped out, so I get some photos and videos of how that looked like. But basically, kitchen out, bathroom out, all of the woodwork out from the property, the walls pretty much stripped back where it needs to be to get back to the original brick if the previous bonding and plaster work is brittle. Couple of the frames out, everything pretty much taken out of the property, central heating pipes, electrics being pulled through, and pretty much the first steps required to do this refurb. Now, I like to mention is that when you guys are doing a full cycle BRR property investment, the fact of actually doing a refurb is the most important part. Now I'm going to show you guys around the property, and then I'm going to be breaking through the exact numbers and what should you guys expect when you are doing a BRR property just like this, and how you can achieve a return of over 15% in under 7 months. That's right, well over 15% return on your cash invested in under 7 months with the power of property. This is something that I've shown back to back to back, delivering and doing. Again, I've been doing this for many, many years, and I've documented pretty much all of them. And you guys can see literally the one that I did the month before, the one that I did the month before that, the one that I'm gonna do the month after this, and all the projects I've got going on. I've had a brand new frame put around the entrance of the kitchen. And obviously the reason that we've done this is just for the fact that the previous old one, we couldn't really get away with sanding it and rubbing it and pretty much painting over it. It was in too much of a bad state to achieve the high end look that we're pretty much going for. So we've put brand new frame in this instance all around here. We've got, again, as mentioned, all of the brand new architraves skirting all around. And making way to the kitchen, it is looking a lot different than how you guys previously remember. Now, this kitchen, we purchased it from Howdens, just over £2,000, so pretty much £2,100. And obviously, our own company fits it, and we've done this entire refurb in 1 month and 1 week. Now, I'll get more into how to actually do this refurb, kind of, you know, this is how you would execute a full cycle BRR. Pretty much £2,100 for this entire kitchen that you see here, including the hub and oven and extractor fan. As you guys can see, the way to get this, pretty much these refurbs in cost, is to truly know what to keep and what to remove. If you guys have sourced a BRR property for yourself and you're then going to another builder or, and you know, another company and saying, hey, listen, can you do this refurb? I've only got a budget of 20, 25 grand. And just to mention, this refurb is exactly 24,200. I'll go through all the costs in a little bit, but pretty much you go to a builder and say, listen, I need this refurb done at this exact budget. It all needs to be done brand new. Everything needs to be redone. And then all of a sudden you end up costing yourself 30, 35, 40 grand. Because they don't know what you're looking for. They don't know that you've got that fixed budget. You're expecting everything new, everything done. And that's where the majority of problems lie when people try to do BRRs themselves. They don't know how to do this refurb. Now again, I'll go through that in a lot more detail. And again, I've got my own construction company that we do the refurbs for our investors. But something to pretty much look out for if you guys are doing your own refurbs is to pretty much not spend on things like tiles. Everybody goes in a property and thinks to themselves, you know, I want to make it all nice, you know, tile the walls, tile the bathroom, do this, do that. But these are investment properties. You want to achieve a high end value. Look at this over here. This is what we call UPVC cladding. Now, as you can see, it is an incredibly cheap thing to put, but it makes the property look nice and presentable. And this is exactly what we're looking for. To put tiles on here, it's not really about the cost of material, which yes, this is quite a bit cheaper, but it's about the cost of labor and the time that it takes and kind of what effects it even has. I mean, are they going to pay another 10, 50 pound a month more for the rental income just because it's tiled in the kitchen, or more for the value of the property just because it's tiled in the bathroom? Or are they just walking in to see that it's nice and new? Because there is nothing really like this coming on the markets when we do the refurbs. Making my way further back, I'm just going into the bathroom. As you can see, bathroom looks, again, completely bright, completely redone. UPVC cladding all around, nice and watertight. There will be no damp patches, no moisture buildup. Everything will drip from the ceilings. All of this is done brand new. Again, I've got brand new toilet in here, brand new sink in here, a brand new bathtub in here. Just everything that was required to get the value of the property uplifted. Got brand new towel radiator here as well. Shower heads, everything that's needed, again, to, as mentioned, to get the value of the property up. Architraves all around, redone in the bathroom. And what I want to also mention is that, as you can see in that room, all of those UPVC claddings on the walls only comes to a cost of around about £30 a pack. And then a pack comes around about £8. So to pretty much do this entire bathroom, you can get away with doing it for just over about £1,000 to £1,500 for that entire bathroom. But you guys have to treat it as an investment and go with a company, or at least get the knowledge yourself on how to actually do the refurb to be in budget and when you're working with an end value in mind. As you all know, end values in mind can't really be adjusted. It is what it is. It's what the market pays. You can't overinflate an end value number if you spend nice raw materials. You maybe can when the market's good, but at this level of the market, people are looking for the base completely done up, and this is the end value. If we achieve the top rent, lenders will come in, they'll refinance on it straight away based on the appearance of the property and all the improvements like electrics, gas, central heating, EPC, kitchen, bathroom, and new plaster throughout the entire property. So we're just going to go upstairs throughout this property to show you guys. Now, this is a 3-bed property with the bathroom at back. Now, previously back in the day, I wasn't really a fan of properties that had a bathroom in the back, but to be honest with you, it's all about what is sold on the same road. If pretty much all the other houses are the same thing, and they've all sold, and they've all achieved a certain end value, and they all rent, then that is what it is. There isn't anything more to it. There's no point to say, you know what, let's put the bathroom from downstairs to upstairs, it'll be a lot nicer, I prefer it myself like that. If I'm living in the house, I don't want to go downstairs and go in the bathroom. It doesn't matter, really. It's about the numbers. It truly, truly, truly comes down to the numbers to deliver on property investments. It's an investment at the end of the day. An investor wants to know how much they're buying it for, which is a guaranteed number. They want to know how much they're going to spend on it, which is, again, a guaranteed number through my company. Because as mentioned, we deliver exact refurb numbers in a guaranteed time and a guaranteed cost. That includes gas bills, water bills, electricity bills, council tax bills, EBC certificate bills. All of these costs involved, everything is at a guaranteed number and time frame. Now again, as mentioned, once the investor knows these two numbers, they all know how much the stamp duty is, how much the solicitor fees are, which I'll go through all the numbers, but then it comes down to being comfortable with the end value and what you can achieve with the end value and what you can also achieve with the rental income. So again, you do your own due diligence on that, but that is pretty much how to get yourself into the right deal in the first place. And then it comes down to delivering on this. Me into the back bedroom here, this room had a lot of previous problems. There was a lot of damp on the wall, a lot of previous molds and sort of condensation throughout the entire property. So what we've done is we've put external board insulation, so across the board with insulation on the back, with aluminium backing on back throughout the entire walls, just to pretty much insulate the property, make it a lot warmer, make the property pretty much preventable from any much damp and water from coming in. Now these are again external walls throughout the entire property on the back. So by doing this, that pretty much insulates the property and prevents any water from seeping through all of the foam insulation and the sheet of aluminium from the back of it. We've had, again, as mentioned, electrics pulled through. So previously in this room, there was a socket which you had to pull to switch on the lights. So obviously nobody really wants that inside any room. So obviously we've had the electrics pulled through and had sockets added over there as well. Another thing to mention, obviously, putting through the electrics is that we've raised the electrics all around the floors just to be on specific heights and requirements for the entire property. Being plastered all around, which gives it the nice smooth finish. Everything painted as well by multiple coats. And one thing that, again, as mentioned previously, is to just not paint over wallpaper. Plaster the entire property. If it doesn't make sense on the numbers to buy the property, because you think, I can't plaster, I've got to paint over the wallpapers and paint over the old skirting boards and paint over the old architraves, where I'm going to paint it black, I'm going to paint it blue, but that will do it, it will look nice and I'll get a high end value. That's not how BRR property works at all. You need to do refurbs, you need to make it like a new build. That's how they come in and lend it on a new value. Coming into the second bedroom, as you can see, everything done again, skirting boards, architraves, electrics, all throughout the entire property. We've also had the chimneys capped off from the property as well, just to prevent any water from coming in the future. And we've had them all completely bricked up and plasterboarded and replastered all around as well. One thing I'd like to mention is that, as you can see, we've kept some of the doors. Now you may be wondering, why would you keep some of the doors on a brand new BRR refurb? And the answer for that is because if we were to change the doors that would come into the property are a lot cheaper than these solid hardwood doors. If you can take care of it and paint it and re-sand them, and make them new again, adding new handles, adding new hinges, this is exactly what is required to be in budget. But people don't realize that. They just say, it needs all new doors, it needs all this, the doors don't look good. But that's, again, as mentioned, not how you stay in budget and deliver for investors or for yourself in any fashion. Onto the third bedroom right now as well. As you can see, everything has been taken care of. We've had all of the wallpaper stripped from the entire property, everything taken back to the original walls, external board insulation throughout the entire external walls as well to get the EPC up on the property, all plastered round from top to bottom, chimney capped off, skirting boards, architraves, new handles, new electric sockets, new outlets, everything done as expected. Another thing to mention to get the EPC of the property up from a C plus is obviously we've had insulation put in the loft as well, so that's 200 mil thick. Now I'll be breaking down all of the numbers involved throughout this property. I want to start off by mentioning is that this is a property that I actually bidded on auction. Now I documented the bidding on my YouTube channel and my Instagram page. So I actually bid on this property on auction for the investor. And initially I sent out the projection numbers at a purchase price of 70,500. Now throughout the bid of the auction, I ended up bidding another grand more. So the purchase price came to 71,500. The numbers that I'll be breaking down throughout this for simplicity are the numbers that I initially sent out to the investor before we wanted to bid on the property. Now, I want to mention, usually obviously you're not supposed to bid anything more, but in this instance, I knew I was going to get the property on auction. You know, everybody was bidding, he was bidding, and as soon as you put a bid, bam, I put another bid. As soon as you put a bid, bam, I put another bid. I just pretty much said, I'm having this property deal. Now, the reason why I got this property deal and the reason why I knew I was so comfortable with it was because it had such a solid end comparable. It drew two doors down, sold for over £120,000. And the £120,000 sale a few doors down, basically the inside of the property, it wasn't even that nice. So I knew if we were to get this, we have no problem achieving over £120,000 as an end value. Now, literally, by knowing the end value, I can work backwards on the numbers, deducting all of the costs, deducting the return that I want for the investor, and coming up with a buy price. Now, I know for a fact nobody else can deliver in terms of the refurbishment. Even if they want to do the refurb themselves, they can't outbeat my team, they can't outbeat the prices, they can't outbeat the speed of the time of actually buying the property investment, they can't outbeat the speed of it being cash. So I know that we can buy amazing good property deals throughout the entire market and good deals on the auction. So the numbers presented was purchase price at £70,500. After the purchase price of property, we also have a cost of solicitor fees. Our solicitor fees came to a total of £875 throughout this entire purchase, and I get a completion statement up there as well of the exact cost. Now, the sourcing fee and full management, so again, that's my company's fee, so that's the sourcing fee of finding this property and the full management of this entire refurb came to £2,150. Now, I want to mention, yes, £2,150 to source a property for an investor, achieving over a 15% return, and delivering and managing the entire refurb. And there's a reason for that, because the way my company works is that we work on truly the return for the investor. I mean, this investor's got minimum returns on certain requirements, he's purchased quite a few properties off us, and the fact is, I can't charge more. I would love to charge how other people say it, 3 grand, 4 grand, 5 grand, 6 grand, 7 grand, add capital growth in the return, so on and so forth. But that's not how you deliver and actually truly do a full cycle BRR property investment deal. So sourcing fee for this property was at £2,150. The stamp duty came to 3% of the purchase price, with it being calculated at £70,500. There was also an auction fee cost involved. So as I mentioned, this was from the modern method of auction. So there was a £6,600 buyer's premium throughout the auction as well, which was paid at the start of the reservation when we won the auction bid. Now, adding all of the costs involved in buying the property and getting the keys in the hand
came to £83,554.
Now, this entire process was done in 56 days. Now, the reason that was done 56 days was because it was an auction property, as mentioned, and we had a time limit of 56 days to complete the transaction. So we pushed it towards the end, waiting for another refinance to come from another property that we've done with the investor in line to be able to buy this property that I'm standing in now. So this purchase time basically takes anywhere between 28 days to 56 days when you buy it cash, and generally you buy it with indemnity insurance on the searches to get the speed done. Now again, my solicitor, we've purchased well over 45 properties, so they know exactly how we work and they can get ours completed incredibly well. The refurbishment that you see here, everything included, came to £24,200. This was a cost that we projected previously to the investor, and that was a guaranteed fixed price, including everything. Garden cleaning, full refurb, everything, all certificates, all bills, everything. Not a single thing that isn't included. And I really emphasize that because nobody else can do that. And there is no other builder that will guarantee a number and deliver on that number. There is no other way you can do it in a refurb and have a fixed budget and stick with that fixed budget. On top of that, we had the contingency put aside at £445. Again, as mentioned, that £445 goes towards all of the costs like the council tax, the water bills, and all of the pretty much holding costs while we do the entire refurb. Now, the entire refurb plus all of the costs involved in buying the property brings the full total to
£108,199.
Is done within a span of 2 months of ownership of the property. Now, as I mentioned, we got the property within 56 days, and upon getting the keys to the property, we done this entire refurb in 1 month and 1 week. Generally speaking, we'll do this property refurbishment anywhere between 1.5 months to 2 months, depending on the size of the property, but to do a full BRR refurb, just like you see here, it can be done exactly within 2 to 2.5 to maybe 3 months. And depending on our availability and how many ongoing projects we have, it ranges between 1.5 to 3 months for entire refurb. After the refurbishment is done within pretty much that 2.5 to 3 month timescale, obviously as mentioned, we bring in the agents as well to get it advertised. So today we had the agents coming in to get the photos of the property taken to get it onto the market and advertised. So straight after the refurb is done, pretty much ongoing while things are still happening, the agent's coming in and getting prepared to stick it onto the market. So as soon as the refurb's done and it's hit the market, you should pretty much be looking at about 2 months, or let's say 3 months, from ownership of releasing all of that cash and exchanging completing on the property. So once property is now onto the market, you should generally get an inquiry and a tenant found within the first few weeks. So call that a month. So within 2.5 months, around that 3 month time to build that refurb, while the tenant should be coming in, should be looking at now month 4 of the property purchase. Now, to be honest with you, it goes a lot smoother than that. I've done many of them. We get tenants in within the first few days or first week, and all of this process is squeezed down to incredibly fast time. But I'm just being conservative in terms of just explaining to you guys, if you were to go with other companies or try to do this yourself, you really shouldn't go any longer than that time scale. Straight off, the refurb is done and we get the tenant in the property. We have a decision if we want to keep the property and refinance and rent it, or to flip the property. Now, generally speaking, in this market, we don't actually flip properties anymore. It's a lot easier to just get a tenant in there that's paying a great market value, get lenders in there that are just going to lend on the end value that we projected based on ways that we do the refurb and the schedule of works. And it's just a lot more straightforward and makes the process a lot faster. Just refinance that pot of cash. We then have the tenants in the property paying rent. Now, this property in specific will have the rental income at 775. We've got multiple other properties as well, which all have that pretty much the same type of rental income, 775, 795, depending on the sort of the value of the property. So then the tenant will actually be paying a few months of rental income. Now, what I basically want to also say is I'm going to break through the cost of as if we were to flip the property.
So as mentioned, every single cost, including purchase, refurb, all costs involved, comes to £108,199.
If we were to flip this property, we could achieve bottom end value of £120,000. If we were to have sold it onto the open market, we would incur costs like estate agency sale fees and solicitor fees for the transaction of the sale. Solicitor costs would come to £875, and the sale of the agent fee will also come for another £1,000. So that's a total of £1,875 in costs if we were to flip the property. So that brings the entire total purchase price to
£110,074.
If you were to sell this property for £125,000, you would be left with
£14,926.
Now again, as mentioned, plan is not to sell this property, so we'll be breaking through the costs of the full BRR cycle. Once you've had the property rented for a few months, it's important to understand that the reason why we do this and don't start the refinancing stage straight away is because as soon as you hit that 6 month time scale where you've owned the property for more than 6 months, then you don't have, for example, a sourcing company involved in the bank statements for lenders. You open up to a higher pool of lenders, basically. So as soon as we hit that 6 month time scale, we can pretty much get end values above the projected value that we've already had. So we've now collected rental income at 775 for 3 months. And again, I'm giving you an example. All the other properties, literally on my YouTube channel, the video before that, property 23 Dell Street, it's already now rented, being rented now for 2 months. Coming on to the third month, we're just starting that refinancing stage. That money will come in back into the account onto the next property deal. So again, this investor will be able to complete 4 property transactions with a pot of cash within this year. So again, he's injected some, but I'll get onto that later down the line as well.
So far we've gone through all of the numbers and what the full cash invested would be and what costs would involve if we were to flip the property and sell it back onto the open market, and what profit we would have and what return we would be left. I've mentioned that obviously the plan is not to flip it, and we're going through the numbers as if it's a BRR. This is where the actual full BRR cycle breaks down and the important figures come to play that you guys need to take in consideration of. So basically everything that I've gone through is pretty much all of the costs involved in buying, doing the refurb, every basically cost that every investor would go through trying to achieve an end value or an end finished product of a property investment asset. So now to exit the property, we'll be going through the numbers for the refinancing stage. So as mentioned, we've got rent coming in for about 775, or exactly 775 per calendar month for about a month or two now. It's actually been 3 months, but for the sake of this, you know, you should expect to at least have a month of rental income coming in, and that will be net. You know, you won't have any costs like mortgage payments and so on and so forth that will be going through down. So that will be clean money back into your bank account that you can see working straight away. You'll feel very, very good because there's no debt on the property at that time. Some investors actually, when they hit that stage, they're like, forget it, I don't even want to refinance, take another 150 grand or whatever, let's go on to the next one. But that all depends on the investor and what the outcome and goal actually is. So going through to the numbers now, so at refinance at end value of £120,000, and we've had the valuators and everything that will be going out to refinance it, but for basic terms on the other properties, we set the value at a 130 end value. They knock it back potentially 125 if ever, sometimes you get the end values at 130. We go through worst case at 120 because that's where we break down the cost, but as mentioned, there's one, two, three doors away that has sold for £120,000 as a two-bed, not three-bed like ours, still needed a bit of work, EPCs in the sea, so on and so forth. So it just pretty much depends, but we know what the end values are, what the property's worth, and so on and so forth. So we just go bottom end on £120,000. Let's go through the numbers. So mortgage product fee, now this is a very, very important figure that you have to guys take consideration of. Now everybody knows the base rate at 5.25%. Now you can actually get lending around that same sort of figure, but you actually have to sometimes pay up front a cost. And this is something people aren't aware of. You actually have to pay some money to get that mortgage. You need to pay out evaluation fees, you need to pay, you know, certain things to be conducted to actually get that money back from the refinancing stage. Now, the mortgage product fee is like a percentage. It varies based on potentially even how many properties you have in your portfolio. It can depend on, you know, just generally quite a few things. Now, sometimes some are cheaper up front and then they're increased into the actual loan amount that you pay off monthly interest. But basically, let's just call it the 2%. It can go up to 5%, it can go up lower. You can even get zero mortgage product fees, even cash back mortgage product fees. We just have to kind of calculate, does it make sense to pay this upfront cost to get the mortgage, or to kind of spread out the cost monthly? Do my rent and income cover it? Is there a big enough margin there? How does the return work? So it's actually a little bit of calculation you have to take consideration of to see what do I pay up first and what not. And sometimes you can even get that figure deducted from the amount of money they give you at the end, which just makes your return a little bit better, but you still are paying for it and it is your money and it is cash. But either way, so mortgage product fee at 2%, so that's lent at 75%. So they lend at 75% of the end value. So the end value of the product is worth £120,000. So 44 Doncaster Road, end value, finished of the property, come in at value of £120,000, bottom end minimum. So 75% of that is £90,000. So £90,000, to basically get, you basically take that 2% and you get 2% of that £90,000. So the full amount of money that they're going to be giving back to us are going to be lent back. So it'll come back into the investor's pocket, basically back into the investor's bank account. To get that money back in, you're going to pay up front 2%. So 2% comes to £1,800. Again, varies, but we'll go through the numbers now. So we've got £1,800 of cost here. Then we've got solicitor refinancing costs. So to get that money back, ask for a solicitor. They sometimes have to do some searches they haven't done previously and then have done indemnity previously. So then you're going to have £694 of cost to pay your solicitor as well. You've got a tenant fine fee as well. So that's a cost that I maybe should have mentioned previously, but to obviously get the property rented, you're going to have to get maybe an agent or something like that to be able to find you that tenant. Some of our landlords actually find the tenant themselves. That's very, very rare. Obviously, we take care of investors' portfolios fully, really hands-off completely. Some of them are not even in this country. But obviously, you're going to have some things like that. For the house of 44 Doncaster Road that we're talking about, the management, the actual tenant fine fee was only like £350 or something, even less, £310 or something like that, just for the sake of our relationship with the estate agents that we have all buying properties for them, giving them back, and so on and so forth. But it's a cost that you guys have to take consideration of. So full cash invested being the... So now I'm just actually going to come back and say, so all of these costs is what you would call your refinancing cost. So that comes to £2,964. So that's going to be your cost that you're going to have to take consideration. You're going to need to have cash there that you're going to be putting into this investment to be able to get that money back out and get leverage on that property and get your investment working for you on a 6 month or 1 year ASD contract and start to see some proper returns on your investment. So full cash invested then becomes that cost plus also the full cash invested here at £108,199, which comes to £111,163. So again, that's all of the money that the investor will be paying to get this, you know, this full recycled investment going ahead. Now, 75% of the £120,000, basically the amount of money they're going to give back to us is £90,000. So now that we actually know the full cash invested, which is all of the costs, the refurb, the purchase, all the costs to get the tenant in the property, to pay for the bills, pay for the council tax, pay for the sourcing company, pay for the management process of it, pay for the everything from top to bottom, pay to get the loan, pay to get everything sorted out, pay your broker, get paid your solicitors, everything from there, which I really emphasize on because people don't take into consideration of it and they don't even know how to calculate their investment and they just think of it as, I'll just buy a house, it's good, it's a house, whatever. But you know, you can make serious money if you just buy it one and go ahead on it. But either way, coming back to that, so we've got the full cash invested here at £111,163 minus the amount of money that the bank is giving back to us or the lender or whoever, comes to £21,163. So full cash invested, £111,163 minus 90 grand, which is the amount of money they've given back to us. We've already factored in all the costs there into this side of everything. Comes to £21,163. So now that is the money left in the property investment. So this is the important number that you guys have to take consideration of for starters. So this is the full amount of cash that the investors got left in the property investment after getting the finance, after sorting everything. He's not gonna have to put any more money in there, zero. There is no more, I've now got leverage, now I need to pay for this, now I need to pay for this, or I already bought it with a mortgage, so I'm paying builders, so how does my return actually work? I've just spent 50 grand and I'm paying back interest on that. It just doesn't work like that. So this is why I say buy cash or buy bridging or whatever. Do this entire process cash until you get about here. I've gone through the time scales of it, whatever. Coming, jumping back a few steps. If you were to sell a property, it takes about a month and a half to about 3.5 months to sell it as well. Jumping back again, I've gone through all those things. But going back to here, so we know the full cash invested in the deal at £21,163. So now if we were to get, obviously, the mortgage, we've got to pay interest on that mortgage. We'll go for an interest-only mortgage because it is a property investment. You're not paying back the debt of it, don't need to. It's designed to make money. You just got to see how much return you're going to be getting. That's when the capital uplift goes up, your deposit will also increase as well, which is a great thing about property. So 4.8%, you may think of it as quite low. Yes, it's potentially low. It does differ, or like I mentioned, depends on how much percentage you sometimes paid up front as well. So take consideration of the cost of that. Speak to a mortgage advisor. We've got a mortgage advisor that works with me. I got his contact number from an investor of ours who's got over 200 properties. So he's absolutely amazing, can get things pushed through very, very well. If you guys are interested as well, don't get commission or anything like that. I'll put you in contact and so on and so forth. If I get on further down the video. So we've got 4.8%. So 4.8% of the £90,000 comes to £4,320. Divide that by 12 to find out what do we pay monthly for the amount of money that we're gonna be paying back in the interest, which is 4,320. So that comes to £360. So we're gonna be paying £360 every single month on the loan for this property. So now we're gonna also take consideration 10% management fee. Now throughout this property, we actually manage it for the investor ourselves. We do a much lower management fee. Some investors manage it themselves. You know, we can get with agents sometimes 7% management fee, including VATs or whatever, it all depends. We just put it in as 10% including VAT. So you can get that, I mentioned you can get 80%. So that comes to £62 per annum. So that's another cost you're gonna be taking in consideration. So we've got £360 of cost for your mortgage, £62 cost for management. You've got maintenance of voids, another £50, it's a new property. You're gonna have the voids there because you're just finishing it. And we actually, you know, take care of everything until it's got to that stage. So you've got £50 of voids put aside every single month, it adds up. Sometimes something may go wrong. You know, you've got £200 saved up that can be put forward to there. You've got your insurance costs as well, another £22 per calendar month. So these are your outgoing costs that you pretty much put aside and know that you're going to be taking consideration. So the monthly costs come to £494. So every single month, your outgoing for this property is going to be £494. Now, as mentioned, it's been let and it will always be let. And this is based on the fact of it having rental income. And so £775 per calendar month minus your monthly outgoings comes to £281 per calendar month profit. Now, this is done pretty much straight away. As mentioned, you've got rental coming in without all of these costs involved previously. So instead of having £281 per calendar month profit, you're going to be having, you know, pretty much close to that full rental figure at £775 minus your insurance and potentially, you know, your management fees and so on and so forth. But you're going to have that big £360 of interest cost in there. So we've got £281 per calendar month of profit. So that comes to a yearly profit of £3,372. So money there that you've got there, or that property that you've got there, is cash flowing you at a relatively high interest rate in this economy, although everything is pretty good actually. £3,372 per calendar month, which is pretty damn good. Now the best part about it is that the most important thing is how much money is your actual cash flow based on a return on your full cash invested. So if your full cash invested is a crazy low number, but your monthly profit is also a crazy low number, that can have a big impact. If you can potentially sometimes even leave in 100 grand in the deal, you may think that's not a good deal, 100 grand a deal. But then you've got to look at how much profit you're making on that every single month, pretty much. What's your return on investment? What is your monthly profit, pretty much? So now I'm going to get through to the best part where you actually get to see how you calculate that full investment and full return. So you take your yearly profit of the rent, which is £3,372 for that yearly profit, divide that by the full cash invested,
£21,163.
All the money left in the deal comes to a 15.93% return ROI, return on your cash invested. Cash invested £21,163, your monthly profit, pretty your yearly profit comes at £3,372, giving you a 15.93% return. Now the best part is I haven't factored in things like capital growth, where this area, you know, over a 5-year time scale, you've got minimum capital growth of 2%, goes up after 10 years and so on and so forth. But it is an amazing way to grow a pot of cash through basically property. Now, it's a lot more to it. It comes on finding the deal, doing the refurb, being knowledgeable, doing multiple, knowing how to spend on the refurb, knowing how to calculate end values, knowing how to exit, knowing how to secure the deal. There's a lot of things involved in it, but it's something that definitely is an amazing way. And we've done it for multiple investors and keep doing it at a flawless recycle and continuous stage. So if you guys are actually interested in us being able to find you property investments like this, pretty much just fill out your details down below on our website, www.mrmpilot.co.uk. You know, if you've got pretty much roughly this amount of cash there, potentially even more, you know, we can find your property like this, we can source it for you, we can do the entire refurb from start to finish, a guaranteed quote, all of it, get you guys exit out, everything needs to be done, and just recycle that process through. So I'd love to have a chat with you guys. On another hand as well, if you guys are interested in pretty much a company, if you guys are an investor that is looking for a sourcing company like mine to be able to source you a property investment deal and deliver entirely on the refurb at a guaranteed number and timescale, then please fill out your details down below. I would love to have a chat. You guys can come and see my ongoing projects, see all the properties that I've done, speak with my investors, you know, see all the projects that I'm doing, every single thing like that. I would love to come and show you guys around, get an understanding of if we can be a good fit and work together. Since my last YouTube video I've uploaded, I've taken on some new customers, so one of them actually came through YouTube, which is a great thing, and it's something that I would love to also share and just put everything out there for you guys. So please also consider hitting that subscribe button, and thank you very, very much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye.